Hello, welcome to Coffee's Corner, and I'm Ella Coffee, your host. Welcome back this week. We're filming, as always, at Springfield College, which you can find here on the corner of Dr. Martin Luther King and Falkenberg Road. We have a really exciting show today. I'm excited about the information we're going to be providing to the community. At any time, if you have information, community news, or events that are taking place, and you'd like to get that information out, you can contact us at tampanewsandtalk.com. Today, we're going to be talking with two dynamic guests that are activists in the community and very busy and always keeping folks informed of what's happening and making sure that you're aware of things that are best for you. We're joined today by Ms. Dianne Hart and Ms. Heddie Sumpter. Ms. Hart, please introduce yourself. Let the community know.
My name is Dianne Hart, and I'm president of the Hillsborough County Democratic Black Caucus here in the city of Tampa. I'm also owner of Ms. D's World of Beauty. And it's my pleasure to be here with you this evening, Ella.
Thank you. Ms. Sumpter.
Good evening. My name is Heddie Sumpter, and I have many hats that I wear in the community. Unfortunately, this evening I'm here to represent the Hillsborough County Democratic Black Caucus. We're very excited about our upcoming 30th Annual Conference for the Democratic Black Caucus of Florida. So again, thank you, Ms. Ella.
Thank you so much. And we appreciate you coming on. We've got some exciting things happening here in Tampa over the next couple of months. 2012 is going to be a very exciting year in the political arena. I think the Republican Party has pretty much made their decision on who their nominee is going to be. But what we have going on here in Tampa, the excitement that's going to be taking place here, we have some events coming up over the next few months here in Tampa, and the Democratic Black Caucus is going to really kick it off. We're going to start those events that are taking place here in Tampa. In May, we are having a weekend full of events and wonderful speakers. So let's just talk immediately. Let's just go right into talking about who our guests will be, starting that weekend of May 11th through the 13th.
Well, we're very, very excited because the speaker for our event, which will take place on May 12th, we'll kick it off on May 11th, which is a Friday night, and that event will be a lawyer's reception, and it will be with the Professor Charles Ogletree, who is President Obama's former law professor, both he and Michelle, in fact, previous law professor. He's also a dynamic speaker. In addition to having him, we will have Attorney Willie Gary, who a lot of people are very familiar with. So those are just two of our dynamic speakers that we'll have over those 2 days, Friday and Saturday.
And Ms. Hart, don't forget to mention the fact that Professor Ogletree will there also be a book signing with his latest book, Presumption of Guilt. So if you have not bought it already, please feel free to do so, or we will have them available for sale at the function throughout the weekend. So we're really excited about that opportunity, as well as Attorney Willie Gary will also have some of his books available for sale.
So on Friday night, Professor Ogletree is going to come into town, and we're going to have a gathering, and we're meeting actually at the Embassy Suites.
Right.
So we will have a gathering on Friday evening and give the community an opportunity to come out and meet with Professor Ogletree, talk about his book, have his book signed at that time as well. What are some of the other events going on that weekend? On Saturday, I know we have a couple different items we're pushing and we want to make sure the community is aware of because we'd like them to come out and join. Let's talk about those events that's happening on Saturday, workshops that we're preparing for the community.
And before we begin to talk about the workshops, we want to mention the fact that we have some very dynamic honorary co-chairs for this event. Our own Mayor Bob Bullhorn has agreed to be a co-chair, as well as Senator Arthenia Joyner, Representative Betty Reed, and Congresswoman Kathy Castor. So we're very excited that they have lent their support to this event.
Okay. Well, on Saturday, as you know, we're going to have some breakout sessions, and of course the public is certainly welcome to come out and partake of that. We're going to do a piece on voter suppression and the GOTV, Vote From Home, how important that is. And we're going to have a 2012 legislative session review on the redistricting, which you know is just critical.
So the session of GOTV, GOTV means get out the vote. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in our second segment because we have some information we want to make sure that the viewers are aware of, and they're very knowledgeable on the options they will have when it comes to actually casting their ballot. But we'll talk about that in depth in the second segment. But on Saturday, the 12th, you'll have an opportunity to become a register with the conference and come out and enjoy all of the workshops and the information that we're going to be sharing. Also on Saturday, we're going to have what's called a State of Black America, where we're going to have a roundtable scenario and a panel where we'll have some of the state legislators, we'll have some key folks here in Tampa and throughout the state, because this is actually the Democratic Black Caucus State Convention. It's not just Hillsborough County, it's the state convention, and we have many chapters throughout the state that will be participating with us this weekend here that we're hosting here in Tampa. So on that Saturday, we're going to have some of the legislators talk about where we are right now in America, where we are in the political world in America, and how we can become more of a force in that political world. A lot of times we feel disenfranchised because we see politicians during the election time and nothing happens between those 2 year or the 4 year cycles. So we really want to teach our community how to become more active and how to pretty much demand the power that we actually have to make sure that we're receiving that acknowledgement that we are a community and a community that needs to be reckoned with. So those are the events that are taking place during the day on Saturday, and Saturday night is our gala event, which is really something spectacular because we have two dynamic folks that's in the law profession that's going to be here in Tampa to really kind of talk about some of the things that they've witnessed across the U.S. because they both are traveling. And the fact that we have Attorney Willie Gary come into town is actually very dynamic. Willie is, I think, stationed out of Jacksonville.
No, I'm not exactly sure where he is now, but he's actually out of South Florida area.
Fort Lauderdale, okay.
South Florida area.
And sometimes we are excited about the guests that we bring into town, and notwithstanding the dynamic attorneys that we have here, but when we have someone of this magnitude, Professor Ogletree and Attorney Willie Gary come into our town, we want to make sure everybody's aware of the activities that are going to be surrounding. Now, from what I understand, Attorney Gary will be the master of ceremony for us that evening, which I'm really excited about, and looking forward to listening to him, because the history and the knowledge that he holds on some of the cases that have really been profound, and that he's really been a landmark person in those cases, and that we have him here in the state of Florida. Professor Ogletree, now I know he's been to Tampa before and recently, but he's coming back this time to specifically talk about
politics,
and are you in? Will our community be involved in the 2012 election? Tell me about some things. I know you've been talking to the professor, Ms. Sumpter. Tell me about some things that the professor has indicated he wants to kind of make sure that we in Tampa are aware of, the state is aware of what's going on.
Well, you know, with the current climate, particularly for the state of Florida now with our Trayvon Martin case, that's like, it's not something that you would want to have happen on a daily basis, but now that it has received such national recognition, I think that he will be able to, as the weeks unfold up into the conference, that we will have a whole lot more information to be able to discuss, or for him to be able to address, particularly now that there has been some decisions made in that case as far as the arrest. So that's going to be something very important for the community. And also just want to say to the community that please, we encourage you to come out and to attend the gala. You will be very satisfied and just extremely pleased, I believe, with what we have planned. The committee is working very hard to ensure that you enjoy yourself, as well as we bring in these very high profile individuals to the city of Tampa.
I would just like to add that not only is he going to talk about some of the issues that Heddie just mentioned, but he's also going to talk about the disrespect for our president. I believe that he will stop a little bit for President Obama while he's here in the city of Tampa, because he realizes, and I actually had an opportunity to hear him a couple of nights ago talk about how people are disrespecting the president, and they're acting as if though the president has not done anything. And he's going to clear that up for a lot of people who will be at that gala. They'll get an opportunity to hear him talk about some of the accomplishments that the president has made. As you know, Ella, he did serve in the president's as a senior advisor to the president when he initially went into office.
During that transitional period, I do remember that.
Yes.
So Friday night, you folks in the community will have an opportunity to come out and talk with Professor Ogletree about some of the things that's going on and have that one-on-one contact with him. Once again, that event's going to be held Friday night at the Embassy Suites. The reception is at
6 o'clock. It's from 6 to 7:30. At the Embassy Suites, 513 South Florida Avenue, downtown Tampa. And from 8 until 11, we'll have a little reception with music and dancing, eating, networking event immediately following the little the reception with the professor.
Now, if you'd like to get some information, you can go on to the website. Mm-hmm. And the website is HillsboroughCountyDemocraticBlackCaucus.com. That's HillsboroughCountyDemocraticBlackCaucus.com, and it's all spelled out. And you can get all the information on all of the details and the events that are taking place that weekend. So Friday, we have our reception with the professor. And on Saturday, we will have three workshops that you'll be able to be involved in. Saturday, we'll have the luncheon. And then after the luncheon, we will have our State of Black America in Politics. Something similar to the Tavis Smiley style event that will be going on right here in Tampa. And then that evening, we will join in the gala with the title of RUN. This convention is about RUN. Are you fully committed to making sure that the next 4 years, President Obama's in office? And not only that President Obama's in office, the biggest problem that the president really has right now is not that he doesn't have a clear agenda and that he hasn't set an agenda.
Right.
The problem he has is Congress.
Right. Yes.
He can't get his agenda passed through Congress based on the Tea Party sending about 90 folks into it. Right. So it's about, are you completely committed to being a part of this team for the next 4 years? And why it's important for us, of course, to vote during the presidential election, and why it's important for us to vote during the general election. Once again, our honorary chairs are Mayor Bob Buckhorn from the City of Tampa, Congresswoman Kathy Castor from District 11, Senator Arthenia Joyner from District 18, and Representative Betty Reed from District 59. The conference is Friday, May the 11th through Sunday, May the 13th. It's being hosted here in Hillsborough County at the Embassy Suites. Information you can reach at the website HillsboroughCountyDemocraticBlackCaucus.com or via email at hcdbc2012@yahoo.com. I'm Ella Coffey, your host of Coffey's Corner. We're going to take a quick break. We're here filming at Springfield College, which is on the corner of Dr. Martin Luther King and Falkenberg, and we'll be right back. Welcome back. I'm Ella Coffey, your host of Coffey's Corner, and we certainly thank you all for tuning in this week. We're filming here at Springfield College, which is on the corner of Dr. Martin Luther King and Falkenberg. You're watching us on TampaNewsAndTalk.com, and we're here today talking about some really important items that are coming up and events that are going to take place here in the community. We're here with our guests, Ms. Dianne Hart and Ms. Heddie Sumpter, and we're talking about the 30th Annual Conference of the Democratic Black Caucus of Florida. And we're asking you, the community, are you in? Are you going to be in 2012 and fully committed to ensuring that President Barack Obama is elected once again, and why it's so important for our community? One thing we want to make sure that you have all the contact information. If you want to place an ad in the souvenir booklet that we will have, you can get all of that information on the website at HillsboroughCountyDemocraticBlackCaucus.com. If you would like to buy tickets, that information is available as well. Tickets for the gala. What are those prices for the gala on Saturday night?
The tickets for the gala are $75. That's for the gala over at the convention. And the gala will be held at the convention center.
And let's talk a little bit about the ads and the pricing for the ads. And
right. Well, we really solicit the support of the community with buying the ads, because the proceeds from this conference will go to help caucuses throughout the state of Florida with their Get Out the Vote campaigns throughout the rest of the year up until it's time for the election. So that's what their purchasing of the ad will go for. And the ad prices are: the inside back cover is $200, a full page is only $150, and a half page is $100, a fourth of a page, $55, and the business card size is $25. And with the inside back cover, the full pages, of course, you can have your pictures in those ads, and we would greatly appreciate the community support.
What's the deadline if they want to get their ad
the
information
deadline
in?
For ads information is April 25th, 2012. And again, you can send the ads electronically to the website.
All right. Or reach you by email, hcdbc2012@yahoo.com. You talked about the proceeds going back into the community.
Yes.
and making sure that we're helping to get folks out to vote. Tell us what that's going to partake with.
Well, what that does, Ella, for us is it gives us an opportunity to do some visibility for the president, and not just for the president, but also for some other Democratic candidates that may be running in your particular area. What we do is we actually put boots on the ground, and by boots on the ground, that means people knocking on doors, people able to wave signs for you, people putting signs out for you, because a lot of candidates may not have the extra money to do that. But these dollars that we raise goes back into helping to do just that out in our communities throughout the state of Florida.
When we talk about putting boots on the ground and making sure we're getting folks out to vote, one of the things that our community is kind of fretful of is voting by mail. Can we talk a little bit about voting by mail and why it's so important for us to understand and trust the voting by mail process?
Voting by mail is a crucial, crucial piece of going to the poll, I mean, of voting, period. Because a lot of times people don't have the time to make it to the poll in time. They're running behind. They don't go vote early. But if they vote from home, it's in the privacy of their own home. They get to take their time, mark their ballot, get it in the mail. It is very, very secure. The one thing that we're pushing very, very hard for is for our seniors who want to vote from home. Or if you signed your ballot, your voter's registration when you're 18 years old, surely your signature is different now that you're 50-something years old. We're asking you to please re-sign a voter's registration form. That's to update your signature on your voter's registration card, and that's going to be critical on the vote from home piece. So we really want you to take part in that.
And also with the vote from home, that alleviates you being challenged at the polls.
Yes.
Because that will happen. As we were talking about putting boots on the ground, there are other people who are putting boots on the ground to be able to question your ability or your right to vote. So this being able to vote from home totally alleviates that. And even though the early voting days have been shortened to 8, that's still 8 days as opposed to the 1 day we used to have years ago. So I'm still very encouraged and encourage you to please vote for home as soon as those ballots are available to go and utilize that opportunity.
We talked a little bit about the vote by mail and the early voting. Here in Hillsborough County, early voting actually is, the elections are decided before Election Day.
Yes.
And I think we need to start just being honest with that, about that with our community. The Republican Party actually outnumbers us when it comes to voting by mail.
Yes, they do.
And they're making their decision ahead of time, and they're getting their ballots, and then those ballots are counting. And we're kind of countering that with the early vote numbers. And on Election Day, I think maybe the smaller races may be making a difference on Election Day. But we've got to remember that whatever the rules of the game are, we need to
yes,
know the rules
that's
of the
right.
game
right.
and play by the rules. And right now, the rules of the game is really getting out there and getting your vote cast early. And as Ms. Sumpter was saying about not being challenged, there was an article in the paper a couple days ago, front page, as a matter of fact, of the Tampa Tribune, talking about a new organization that's based out of Houston, that they're training folks to go into the polling sites to challenge. Now, in 2008, with President Obama's campaign, I know at that time there were attorneys that were at polling sites, that were there helping folks that may have questions or issues while they're trying to cast their vote. But if you are challenged, do not be discouraged and walk away. That's a right that people have in America to challenge, to ensure that you're voting and that you're registered to vote and you have the right to vote. So don't be discouraged if that should happen. If you are going out on election day to cast your ballot and something takes place, you can always contact the Supervisor of Elections office directly.
Yes.
And their number is 813-744-5900. So if there's a problem on election day, you can contact them. Now, prior to that date, because that's the last day that you can cast your ballot, prior to that date, as Ms. Hart said, we want to make sure that your addresses are correct and updated. We want to make sure that your signature, if you've married, maybe divorced, your name has changed, you need to update that information just as you would have with your driver's license.
And Ms. Coffey, I also would like to encourage members of the community to actually work with the Supervisor of Elections office. I am a clerk, and I've been a clerk for several years. And just having someone that looks like you at the different offices throughout the election process is also something that we could do as well as those as the other people who are training people to challenge us. But we need to be educated about the election process ourselves and also offer ourselves up to actually work in the system. And the Supervisor of the Elections office gives you ample opportunities to attend training, so whatever. So I think that that's something that we could encourage our community
to become a part of that process
yes,
as well.
For sure. And they get paid to actually work.
Right. You are paid for that day.
Office.
Correct. Now, back to the boots on the ground really quick. If I am someone who's out in the community looking for a job and maybe want to do some work during the election time, how would I get in contact with you?
You're going to be able to call me directly. You'll be able to call my cell phone at 813-748-0952, and we will be able to actually find your campaign that's looking for somebody to work with them. We did it before in the 2008 election. We did it in the mayoral election. So and we're doing it not for me personally, but for the Hillsborough County Democratic Black Caucus. Because we've worked so well with our candidates in the past, we are always given that opportunity to help them find people to work for them during the election process.
Let's just talk very briefly again about the conference to make sure that all of the information that is available that the community is aware of. So the conference is being held
in Tampa, Florida, May 11th through the 13th. It will be held at the Embassy Suites, downtown Tampa, 513 South Florida Avenue. That's where we will have our breakout sessions. That's where the lunch will be held. And then on Saturday night, we will actually have the gala at the convention center directly across the street from the convention center. Now, anybody that would like to stay at the Embassy Suites, we have a block and it's being held until
April 20th.
You can make your reservations. That way you don't have to go home on Saturday night. You can stay and be at the hotel on Sunday morning. For those of you who might want to even celebrate Mother's Day on Sunday morning by bringing your parent with you possibly to the gala, then you'll be at the Embassy Suites.
And also, Ms. Hart, we have failed to mention that we have invited our Congresswoman, Debbie Wasserman Schultz, who is the chair of the Democratic National Committee. And so we're hoping that she'll be our speaker for the luncheon. So we have received support from the National Democratic National Committee.
So Saturday night, the event, cocktails are at
6 o'clock.
6 p.m. and
yes.
Dinner and seating takes place
at 7 o'clock p.m.
7 p.m. and that's happening at the Tampa Convention Center and that's on May the 12th. Once again, the website is Hillsborough County Democratic Black Caucus.com. And if you'd like to get any information, please, please go to that website. Ms. Hart, anything you'd like to add?
I'd just like to say, in addition to taking part in our 30th annual convention, please, please do whatever it is you need to do to be ready to vote for our president. It is critical that you get your credentials straight if you want to wait until election day, but we're advising you, please, vote from home. That's a critical, critical piece. If you do that, you cannot lose because your ballot will be counted early.
Ms. Sumpter?
Again, I want to thank the community and in advance for what they will come out to help us to do, particularly with helping to fund the conference. And again, the proceeds will go directly back to the other caucuses throughout the state of Florida.
Once again, this convention is the statewide Democratic Black Caucus convention. It's just being hosted here by Hillsborough County Democratic Black Caucus. Dr. H. Bruce Miles is the president of the statewide Democratic Black Caucus, who is also here in Tampa. So we want to make sure that you have all the information that you need. If you have any questions, you can go to the website, contact Ms. Dianne Hart or Ms. Heddie Sumpter directly. And we just want to invite you out. We want to make sure that the community is involved. We want to make sure that you're in, that even if you're not supporting all of the candidates that the Democratic Black Caucus may be supporting, it's about you going out and having your voice heard.
Right.
And your vote is your power.
Right.
That's your right. Many people die for you to have that.
That's right.
Right. So we want to make sure that everybody has that opportunity. If you're looking for any work during the elections as well, please contact Ms. Dianne Hart at the Black Caucus. Thank you again for joining us this week at Coffee's Corner. I'm Ella Coffee, your host. We're filming here at Springfield College, and we look forward to seeing you at our next show. You can watch us each week here at TampaNewsAndTalk.com. Thank you. Have a good evening. Thank you all so much.
Thank you for having us. We greatly appreciate it.